You've been pretty smart with your money, right?
Yeah.
Because you've seen other people.
I have my ups and downs, of course. Everybody get their money for the first time and act a fool. Then they go crazy, lose their money. But you got to learn from that.
In the span of 4 years, New York City rapper A Boogie with the Hoodie has gone from living in Highbridge, the Bronx, to wearing a chain that commemorates that district that is worth in excess of 100K. Anyway, that ice cold drip is just one piece in the budding artist's ever increasing collection of bling. I don't know too much about real estate in the Bronx, but something tells me you might be able to get a bachelor pad in the area for roughly the same amount. I mean, okay, it's NYC, so probably not a bachelor pad, but maybe a really nice closet. Boogie's also garnered enough worldwide fame to purchase a mansion in the New York City area that operates as a studio for his record label, and that's on top of the house he already purchased for his family. And then there's the glow-in-the-dark Lambo and the shoe collection that has recently gotten him into more trouble than it was probably worth, but we'll get into all of that and more in just a minute. A quick Google search will show you that A Boogie with the Hoodie has beefed up his net worth to a cool $5 million. As he rapped on a fan favorite A Boogie track, Drowning, I'm gonna win the Grammy, move my family out the projects, which is the first thing he did once he started getting paid. What's going on, guys? It's your girl Azalea Hart, back at it again with another The Rich Life video. Today we're taking a look at A Boogie with the Hoodie. Recent drops in this series include Justin Bieber and Zion Williamson. To keep this party going, we need more requests from you. So how about Lil Yachty or an update on Eminem? You guys let me know in the comments down below, but now let's get into this video. A while since we did this, man, before they were famous, so first a little recap. A Boogie was born artist Julius Dubois on December 6, 1995 in Highbridge, Bronx in New York City. And yes, you did hear me right, his actual name is Artist and the dude is an artist. I mean, talk about speaking it into existence. He began rapping at the age of 12 after listening to 50 Cent and Kanye West. Back then, he developed his craft while attending Eagle Academy and performing in ciphers at lunchtime in the cafeteria. His unique moniker comes from his love for the film Paid in Full, which he used to watch every day when he was 13 years old. Everyone around him took to calling him Boogie after a character in that film, and then Hoodie naturally followed suit, as it was always Artist's clothing article of choice. People started saying A Boogie with the Hoodie, and it stuck. The only other rap name I would have considered is Artist, and that's my real name. After a while, everybody will know me as Artist. Growing up in the streets of New York City, Boogie would often get into legal trouble for selling weed and other narcotics. And after finding out about this when he was 16, his parents moved him away to Florida as a form of punishment and to ensure that he didn't get himself into any more trouble. Despite being exiled to another state and being under house arrest, Boogie managed to graduate from high school at the Performance-Based Preparatory Academy in Fort Pierce, Florida.
Something happened which allowed you to be under house arrest in Miami. We skipped to that. Okay, you're recording.
Port St. Lucie.
Boogie took advantage of all the time he had on his hands during the difficult period to tweak his self-composed rhymes and build an amateur studio inside of the house he lived in. After graduating, he began to focus on music while working different jobs, including construction and pizza delivery. His debut mixtape, Artist, was released in February 2016, and it launched his career. It was so successful, he ended up on Forbes' list of up-and-coming rappers for the year. That summer, he went on tour with the likes of Drake and Future during the Summer 16 tour. After the tour, he co-signed with Drake and also signed a deal to Atlantic Records. After being named as one of the XXL's 10 freshman class for 2017, Boogie released his debut studio album, The Bigger Artist, in September. The album's lead single, Drowning, featured Kodak Black and peaked at number 38 in the US Billboard Hot 100. His follow-up album, Hoodie Season, was released in December of 2018 and debuted at number 2 on the Billboard 200, selling 90,000 copies in its first week. It then reached number 1 on January 14, 2019. It became one of the most played albums of 2019 and placed number 10 on the Billboard 200 year-end chart. As impressive as that feat is, Boogie didn't just rest on his laurels. He would go on to release over 20 songs in 2019 alongside such artists as Ed Sheeran, Rick Ross, Liam Payne, and Summer Walker. All of this work led up to the release of his third album, Artist 2.0, which was released on Valentine's Day 2020. So now that we know how he got all his greenbacks, let's take a look at how he spends them. Like all good kids, once Boogie started making bank, he knew that one of the first things he had to do was show his appreciation to the parents that raised him, even if they did send him almost 1,000 miles away to learn a valuable lesson. That's right, one of Boogie's first orders of business with his cash was to buy a new house for his mother and the rest of his family. His mom posted the following picture to Instagram and said, "So baby boy brought me a house yesterday, and yes, he took me furniture shopping. Thank you, artist." She wrote the entire caption in caps lock, typos and all, so I left those in because I assumed she was just really excited about the thoughtful gift. But maybe, I don't know, maybe he did bring it to her. It could have been a portable house. You know, like one of those wide loads that you see moving down the highway. I mean, you never really know, right? But it probably was just a typo. Of course, as nice as buying a house for dear old mom is, an up-and-coming talent like Boogie needs his own dig to set up shop in. So Boogie bought himself a mansion in a heavily wooded township in New Jersey, which operates as home base for his label, Highbridge the Label. So do you want to know what he calls this place? Highbridge the Label Mansion, of course. Look, if you can't figure it out, this dude is very literal when it comes to naming things. I don't know what to tell you. Despite the decor of this place being rather sparse at the moment, the man has his priorities straight. He makes sure the cupboards are always packed with cereal and that there's always Red Bull in the fridge. The main floor includes a living room with a lot of open space and a fireplace as its centerpiece. It also includes an office that would feel at home in a Sherlock Holmes movie, with antique wooden bookshelves, even if there isn't anything sitting on those shelves at the moment. On his sparse, clutter-free lifestyle, Hoodie had this to say. Some people got that walk, some people, I don't know if you can call it, thinking he's the shit or he is the shit, whatever you want to call it, some people just got that whole look in them. And I don't care about having that look, I just want to connect with people. Despite having his priorities more or less in order, that doesn't mean Boogie is above spending his cold hard cash on other flashy items. You only need to look at the man's jewelry collection to figure that one out. The one piece that he seems to show off the most is a gold chain from Avian & Co., a three-dimensional, two-tone custom Highbridge chain that pays tribute to the neighborhood he grew up in. Avian took pride in the fact that the piece has more diamonds in it than most rappers wear around their neck, with Boogie even putting down a ton of cash on diamonds that are situated in areas that they can't even readily be seen. How much exactly this beauty set Boogie backed up is unknown, but the estimate is at least $100,000. But chains and rings aren't the only thing he likes to spend his money on. Boogie has also recently been seen cruising around town in a brand new neon Lamborghini Veneno Roadster. Now this gorgeous ass car usually goes for around $4.5 million and it's apparently barely street legal. And that's before you add on the no doubt additional expenditure of the neon finish. Damn, like according to most online sources, Boogie's net worth is right around that 5 million mark, so Artist 2.0 is gonna have to move mad units to get this guy back in the red, or in this case, the blue. It very well might be the coolest car I've ever seen though, but only because the Batmobile isn't real. I mean, it's not really real, is it? Bum-ba-room. Bum-ba-room. Wait a second, you're telling me that not only is it real, that Jay Leno owns it? Oh, this world, man, not fair, it's not fair. Anyway, let's get back on track. Now that the holy trinity of homes, cars, and ice are taken care of, let's take a look at one last expenditure that Boogie drops his hard-earned dough on, shoes. Lots and lots of shoes. Boogie clearly has a soft spot for unreasonably priced but comfortable footwear. Rather recently, this passion has gotten him into a bit of trouble. 19-year-old Alex Borrow has accused Boogie of scamming him out of 50 pairs of sneakers worth roughly $10,000. This young man has a reselling business with a client list of who's who's, including Offset, Lil Uzi Vert, and French Montana. But if his story is to be believed, it seems like Boogie will no longer be a part of that list. Alex claimed that Boogie's assistant contacted him in February of 2018 to hook Boogie up with some classic shoes for both he and his mother. The deal was contingent on a good price, and Boogie was willing to promise shoutouts and other benefits for Alex if he was able to hook him up. Alex tracked down pairs of Off-White with Air Max 97s, Pharrell with Adidas NMD Human Races, Yeezy 350 V2s in Frozen Yellow, Beluga colorways, and a variety of Boogie's favorite Air Jordan 11s. Burrow claims that he drove to Boogie's mansion in New Jersey to drop them off, but was told that the cash wasn't ready. He would be wired the funds in a few days. Only a few days came and went, and there was no money. Months went by with no contact. Eventually, Alex saw Boogie and his assistant flaunting the unpaid-for shoes on Instagram. Alex took to social media with his story, and it didn't take long for Boogie to hit him back up. He apologized and said he was unaware of the situation, as did his assistant. Something wasn't adding up, and eventually Boogie returned to Instagram to put an end to the rumors. He said, "Sneaky business went down behind my back with an assistant that was just fired because of the situation. Sorry to the sneaker kid who is blaming it on me. I was going to help him, but he exposed information about me, which made me change my mind. I'll take care of the mistake he made, but I want him to clarify that I never did business with him at all. It was all bad side work from a person I had working for me. I guess the moral to this story is always make sure your side work is on point. Considering how relatively new Boogie still is to the game, I'm sure he still has years and years, if not decades, to iron that out and spend more of his cash on crazy purchases, as long as they are not all the same level as that Lambo. He should be okay. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Taking a deep dive into the type of things robbers spend their money on is always fun. I always want to end one of these videos by saying they really are just like the rest of us, but I never can. Maybe one day. Until then, let me know whose bank account you want an investigation into next, and I'll see you guys in the next video.
Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. Now, we drop a new video each and every day, so here's a recent drop that you might enjoy. We handpicked that one for you because if you like this video, you'll probably like that. We also got playlists like over here, so click on that if you want to see a whole list of a bunch of videos we've dropped in the past. And if you're new to the Fame Gang, be sure to subscribe and turn on them post notifications, and I'll see you guys in another video. Boom!